And so we've got to be toughened up, we've got to realise that it will get tough, and it's getting tougher, and it's going to get tougher for you in the Christian life. You're going to get punched, you're going to get kicked, you're going to lose your job. There are people that are already losing their job. There are people who've been kicked off university courses because they don't agree with same-sex marriage, and they found out, and then they've got kicked off their courses. So you're going to be persecuted. So you've got to get used to it, and you've got to toughen up, and not be a namby-pamby Christian and say, "Pastor, I'm fed up." No, be strong and keep going.
Amen.
If you turn to 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 12. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 12. And we read these words. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 12. I'm sorry I've not written all the verses out today. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 12. It says, "Ye and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus will suffer persecution." Now some said, well, it's only Paul who suffered. No, it says there. It says in 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 12, "Ye and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus will suffer persecution." Okay? So you could be in Sudan with a nice married life, with a nice house in Sudan, with a nice car in Sudan, with your children in Sudan. You go to work and come home and your wife's dead, your children are dead, and your house is burnt because the extremists have come and done that because they hate Christ. And what are you going to do? "Well, God, you meant to be giving me a nice life." No. It says, those who follow Christ will be persecuted. So don't you think we're getting off light today in the church and in England? We're not getting that kind of persecution. But you will be persecuted here in England. And you must be prepared for it. You must accept it in the sense that if you follow Jesus, you know, when I've been street preaching, I've been kicked off my stepladders, I've been punched on stepladders, I've had water thrown at me, I've had all sorts of... I've been a bouncing ball off them stepladders over the last 5 years, people kicking me, punching me. Well, hey, it's just part of the job, isn't it? Just get on with it. But be tough in the Lord. And then finally, blessings in the vine. John 15. John 15, and if you look at verse 7, John 15, verse 7, "If we abide in Christ, if you abide in me, my words abide in you, you shall ask what you will, and it shall be done unto you." A guy came up to me yesterday, he was a Jewish guy, and he said, "I've been praying." He's a Jew, he doesn't know Jesus, didn't trust in Jesus. He said, "I feel God's far away from me, and he doesn't hear my prayers." And I said, "Well, think about the Messiah." I told him about Jesus. But we who know Jesus, we who know the Messiah, so we follow him. The Lord promises power in prayer. "If you abide in me, and my words abide in you, you shall ask what you will, and it will be done unto you." There'll be power in your prayer, and there'll be joy in your life as you abide in Christ. Verse 11. John 15, verse 11. "These things I have spoken unto you, that your joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full." And God will pour joy into your life as you obey him. So we've come to the end. I'll just recap quickly as we come to the end. We're connected to the vine. It's the Lord's will that we bear fruit. If we're not bearing fruit, we need to ask why we're not bearing fruit. Are we truly saved, or have we backslidden? And if we're backslidden, we need to get back on track and start bearing fruit. Drinking from the vine, we need to meditate much on the love of God. Obedience in the vine, it's not hairy-fairy feelings, it's obedience to the word, to the commandments of God. Difficulties in the vine, There will be persecution in your life. Accept it and keep following the Lord, and then blessing in the vine. There'll be blessing in prayer and joy in your life as you obey Christ. God bless you. Father, Lord, we can easily lose our way, be distracted by all sorts of things, Lord. But Lord, we want to come back to the vine today. We want to rest in you. We don't want to take our eyes off you, Lord. We want to bear fruit in our lives. We want to have power in prayer. We want to have your joy. And Lord, we pray that you strengthen us when we're persecuted. And Lord, we pray that you would help us to drink of your love, to not get discouraged or down, but to realize your love is great and your love refreshes us. So Lord, I pray for each person here today that in some way this little bread that was shared, that just might feed their soul and bless them in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Worship your songs. We are offering our prayers. Amen.
Amen.
You may stand.